Quite interesting to be speaking after hearing diverse thoughts of Mr. Pehwa, Mr. Tavetia, and Mr. Kabra. But I would like to say that these are the same things that we heard during the consultation process too. We heard on one side, you know, represented by the telecom service providers and their associations, which talked about that, you know, how if we do not allow differential pricing, how it will stifle innovation, you know, internet access would not be provided. And then there would be investment would not come into the sector, and all those points which were made by Mr. Tavetia. And then on the other side, we heard other set of stakeholders and the views of which were represented by Mr. Pehwa, what he said, and, you know, those things. And then the points that you also made in your presentation, you know, that what you said right now. So we heard all these thoughts which were there. And I must say that it has been a very interesting consultation process that we had, and we received some very well-researched and well-reasoned responses to the consultation paper. But I must begin by saying that though we are talking about net neutrality, the topic is net neutrality beyond, but if you see the consultation paper that we floated was typically talking about differential pricing for data services. So we have restricted ourselves to the tariff part of it. We have not, you know, addressed other larger aspects of net neutrality which are there. And the regulation which we came up on 8th of February 2016 also essentially talks about prohibition of discriminatory prices for data services. And now here I would like to mention three things. If you see, the title itself talks about discriminatory tariff for data services. And we go on further to define what are data services in the definition part of it, and then we come to the content. So if you see, the whole focus of the regulation is on content which is there on the internet, the content which is accessed, transmitted or received through the internet. Now coming to the internet, in the consultation process also we had talked about two principles which we were concerned about, which was non-discrimination and transparency. So these are the things when we looked at the comments which were received and the architecture of the internet as has been, you know, pointed by some of you. Now when we look at internet, when a TSP is providing internet services, if you see, he's not controlling the internet infrastructure in its entirety. He is sitting at the edge of the internet but has the power to control the access of the consumer to or that wide world that we have of internet, which is open, transparent, non-discriminatory. So that's, you know, how we started off. And while giving the regulation, while coming up with the regulation, if you see the explanatory memorandum, touches upon all the points based on which we came up with this regulation. It first talks about the technical aspects which we looked into, the economic aspects, the social aspects, and the legal aspects. So the technical aspects which were there was the architecture of the internet and the point that you made, that, you know, it will, you know, you say that it will mold the consumer's choice. You know, that's what we have said, that maybe in the medium and the short term, maybe it may not happen so, but in the long and in the medium and the long term, it may so happen. So then we go on to talk about the economic effects, where we talked about the network effects, we talked about, you know, search, whether they are search goods or, you know, other type of goods. And then we go on to talk about network externalities. So we looked at it from an economic point of view. Then we also looked at the legal aspect. If you see, when you see the recital of the regulation, we talked about two particular specific point. One is 36.1, which is the power of TRAI to come up with a regulation, but the other two points that we made were related to 11.1b1, which is compliance to the license conditions, and the second one is 11.2, which is the tariff. So if you see, as per the license conditions, whether it's an ISP license or it's a unified access service license, the duty of the service provider to give unrestricted access to internet. So that's there. So that was the legal point. And then we also touched upon the freedom of expression, which is there, the plurality of, you know, the thought process, which is there in the big open, non-discriminatory internet that we have. And the essential point that we were trying to basically make is that the service provider has to play the role of a transport carrier, and it has to be application agnostic. That's the fundamental thing that we are saying. And the point that you made that, you know, if somebody wants a higher speed and if somebody wants a lower speed, and if you know that we are not, if you want higher speed and you're willing to pay and you're giving access to the full internet, that's not what the regulation is restricting. Lastly, while we came up with a final regulation, we also, you know, touched upon the point which was made by the telecom service provider was, you know, forbearance, case-by-case approach, versus whether we come up with upfront and ex-ante regulation. So we have, if you see the explanatory memorandum towards the end, also looked at both the paths, why we have not gone in for a case-by-case approach, where we have talked about, you know, if we go by case approach, we felt that it would lead to regulatory uncertainty. You know, you may have launched a product and then you may wait whether, you know, whether this will go through or not. So there is regulatory investment uncertainty. There may be, you may be a little hesitant in offering a particular data offering. And then there is a social cost. There is a cost of regulation. So looking at all those aspects, we said that it is better to go ahead with an ex-ante regulation. However, we are mindful of how the regulation may pan out during its implementation process. And if you see, we have very clearly mentioned that we will review the regulation or if required earlier, as the case may be. So it's not that TRAI is not conscious of the fact that what effect the regulation will have on the growth of internet in the country, or is not aware of the various aspects which lead to growth of the internet. So this was essentially the thought process which led to the, you know, how we came about the regulation, which is on, you know, prohibition of discriminatory tariff for data services. And I would be very happy to, you know, if there are any questions and answers subsequent to that, we'd be happy to answer it.